Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over how to create a dashboard of a pivot table inside of Microsoft Excel. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So here I am in Microsoft Excel, and I've created a list of my expenses for the month of November. If you'd like, you could download our sample Excel file and follow along with us. And I'm going to go down here on the tab for this worksheet, and I'm going to double click and just rename this to data. And then I'm going to click this plus right here and call this sheet dashboard. And then I'm going to click this tab right here and hold down the left mouse button and drag to the left so that my dashboard is the first tab that you see when you open up this workbook. Next, I'm going to go up to any cell you would like to go to for your dashboard. And I'm going to go up here to cell B2. And I'm going to go to Insert, Pivot Table, from Table Range. And I'm going to be prompted right here to select a table or range. I'm going to hit the up arrow and then hit on data and go over here and just select all of the data that I have inside my table. I can either select these cells or I can just select the columns. And both times I am clicking down the left mouse button and dragging to where I want the end of my range to be. Or I can click column A and leave the mouse button down when I click column A and drag to the right. Either one will work. When I'm done selecting my data, I'm going to click this button again and then say OK. And you can see here that my pivot table has been inserted. And I can see the names of my columns right here. So what would I like to display in my pivot table? I think for now, I would like a basic category and the amount. So look under here, you will see that my rows are made up of my categories. And the values that are being shown are a sum total of the amount that I have spent in each category. If I want to, I can highlight here and go up to home, and I can format all of that as currency if that makes more sense. I can also center that. And if I want to, under sum of amount, I can click on this and go to value field settings and just put total at the top and say OK. And this name will change up here for what this column is going to be. And now, if I were to go back to data and say I forgot a few expenses, and I might even have a new category. So let's say our new category is entertainment, and on 11/15, I went to the movies and I spent $15, and I can call this entertainment. And say on the 25th, I went to the theater and I spent $85 also on entertainment. If I go back to my dashboard and I right click on my pivot table and I go to refresh, you can see my entertainment category has been added down here. I can also hit this down arrow and sort from A to Z. And I can also click on that down arrow. And if I scroll down, I can take off the blanks and say OK and not see that blank category. So that's how a basic pivot table works. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. But another part of this is making this page look a little more professional, like a dashboard. I have a lot of options to do that. If I go over to View, I can take off my grid lines, and I can also take off my headings, and I can even take off the formula bar. And this begins to look less like a spreadsheet and more just like a presentation page. If I would like to make this a little more interesting, I could go over here to Insert, go to Illustrations, and go to Pictures, and pick from this device. Let's say I'd like to put our logo in there, and I can move that around anywhere I would like. So let's say I'd like to put that on the bottom right, And then I can also go to page layout and I can click background and hit browse and maybe put in my picture of Excel. But I just wanted you to note that when you have a background in Excel, the pictures will come in as tiled and there's no way to turn that off. So it's possible that you might not like that. So let's delete the background. And if I want to put that picture in, I could go to Insert, Illustrations, Pictures from this device, and just put a copy of the image and just resize it to get it to be where I would like it to be. If I go back to View and I turn the headings back on for a minute, if I want to select all of these cells, I could then go to Home, the Fill Color, and I could pick maybe a light green and have my background look a little bit different. And then if I wanted to go back over to View, I could turn the headings back off. And you can see that my dashboard is starting to look a little bit more like a design and less like a spreadsheet. I can also get rid of the ribbon by going over here and hitting the up arrow. So when I come in here, I can see my dashboard with my pivot table right here, and I can see my data, which looks more like my spreadsheet. So hopefully that gives you a quick introduction to some quick options to create a dashboard inside of Excel. Hopefully you can get creative yourself and create some really good looking dashboards for your spreadsheets that has quick information for people to just look at for a couple minutes and get the information that they need. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.